Hello everyone, welcome to Altair's virtual training of Inspire for Additive Manufacturing. My name is Milan Naval. I'm an application specialist at Altair, and we are going to talk about this virtual training session of Additive Manufacturing from Inspire 2. So the course learning path for Inspire for Additive Manufacturing has some prerequisites, some targeted topics, and then there are other tools within Inspire portfolio. So within prerequisites, we have some basic GUI, which is graphical user interface, geometry functionalities, Inspire for structure analysis, and then performing additive manufacturing solution for 3D printing. Some of the other tools within Inspire platform, we have design and rendering, Inspire Studio, Inspire Render, some manufacturing solutions like Inspire for casting, Inspire for molding, and as we are going to talk about today, we have Inspire Print3D, which is for additive manufacturing. Our training objectives are learning how to use Inspire platform, Inspire Print3D for design of additive manufacturing simulation, and understanding how to incorporate this tool into traditional design process to increase product quality and design better products with minimal training. Inspire Print3D is really easy to learn tool. With this virtual training, you can get started with the tool and learn about how to perform the simulation on structure analysis and for additive manufacturing as well. So in this training, we are going to understand preparing, orienting, sub-creator supports, and slice apart 3D printing according to design preferences. Some of the results that we are going to talk about is displacement and stresses during printing and spring backstages. So we are going to talk about session one initially, which includes introduction to additive manufacturing, introduction to Inspire Print3D itself as a tool, and part selection. Then we'll talk about structure analysis, optimization, and we have a few exercises to go with. All right, let's move to our another presentation. In this presentation, we are going to talk about introduction and optimization for additive manufacturing. So as I mentioned earlier, in this session one, we are going to start with some introduction of additive manufacturing solution and manufacturing process, introduction to Inspire Print3D, part selection, structure analysis, optimization, and some exercises are there. All right, this session is divided into five segments. First segment is introduction to additive manufacturing. Now, what is additive manufacturing? So here we have a simple definition that additive manufacturing is a method of manufacturing where layers of material are built up to create a solid object. Now, this process can be used for prototyping solutions or particular manufacturing of the part. 3D printing for prototyping can be used for rapid design iterations. It is low cost, you can use it for functional prototypes, and it is widely accessible solution. However, on additive manufacturing, as a manufacturing on the actual part, you can perform with a few design restrictions. Very complex designs can be produced with this method. Mass customization can be done. On-demand production, as in opposite to mass production, can be achieved. It is also known for distributed manufacturing. Now, some of the applications in this slide you can see from the process of additive manufacturing or 3D printing, which has a wide range of applications in everyday life. For example, in aerospace and space engineers, automotive industry, robotics and automation, healthcare, entertainment and cinema, product design, and some of the industrial tooling. Now, by the industry, you can see some of the percentage are divided in which industry additive manufacturing is most famous. Medicine, it can be used for 25%. Electronics, it is very well known for 20%. Automotive, 10%. Jewelry, 8%. Food, military, 5%. And some of the examples are given here from the industry who is using this methodology to produce the part. Now let's talk about quickly on 3D printing versus traditional manufacturing. 3D printing offers many advantages in the production of parts compared to traditional manufacturing. Traditional manufacturing includes CNC machining or injection molding or casting manufacturing technologies. So there are many applications where 3D printer is able to deliver design quickly. Also, a complex design and high accuracy can be achieved. And 3D printer builds a digital model which is turned into a physical three-dimensional object by adding material. So a layer by layer material addition and product creation. It is important to understand that 3D printing is rapidly developing technology. Now thinking about with the comparison, which and when to use a particular type of manufacturing process. So when to use 3D printing? If you have a single part which is required, or in terms of you are trying to cut cost, quick turnaround time and if you have a great flexibility in your model or in your part that you want to achieve. However, on other end, you have traditional manufacturing for mass production, of course, high dimensional accuracy and high tolerances, relatively simple geometries and demanding material properties, which is widely available in the market. Now, benefits and limitations of 3D printing. So benefits, it is speed and single step manufacturing, high speed production, of course, complex design can be achieved, cost, you have on-demand production, so you can do a low cost production or prototyping before going for actual production. Risk mitigation, ability to verify design by printing the production ready prototype, as I mentioned earlier, customization of single parts, and large range of specialty materials are also available for plastics and metals. Now, limitations are lower strength and anisotropic material properties, sometimes less cost competitive when the production is made at higher volumes. Limited accuracy and tolerances, sometimes process requires post-processing, require one or more post-processing steps and support removal. Now let's talk about 3D printing process. So in a simple overview, you can see the 3D printing process goes from left to right, from existing designs to 3D printing, then support removals and post-processing. Now talking about the additive manufacturing technologies, right, there are various types of technologies available in the industries and market. And here is the overview. You can see based on requirements, we have technology types, material and powder, defects, post-processing, unpacking, heat treatment, support removal, and blasting. Here are the various types of additive manufacturing processes. So for wet photopolymerization, we have stereolithography, jet light processing, continuous TLP. If it's for powder bed fusion, we have SLS, or also known as SLM, selective laser sintering or selective laser melting, then laser powder bed fusion, electron beam melting, multi-jet fusion. Then others are material extrusion, material jetting, binder jetting, direct energy deposition, sheet lamination. So based on what type of process you are going to use for manufacturing the part, you can choose of various subtypes. Out of all the processes and types of processes, we are going to focus on two major processes because these two are being supported by Inspire Print3D, and you can perform the simulation on these two types of additive manufacturing solution. So very first one is SLS, also known as SLM, which is selective laser melting. We have a short video that show how the powder is distributed on the bed, and the laser, it will melt down and create a shape of first layer, and step by step each layer will get us closer to our final product. For SLS method, here's a slide that shows what are the materials available, energy source, what kind of energy source is being used, strength, weaknesses, application in the industry, dimensional accuracy which can be achieved. Typical build size or most commonly used layer thickness, supports and material cost, as well as the efficiency of shrinkage and warping. The other process is binder jetting or binder sintering jetting. In this process, also this slide shows materials, energy source, strength, weakness, applications, dimensional accuracy, typical build size for a particular product using binder jetting process. Now let's talk about a little bit on 3D printing defects. Overview, where there are some of the most commonly known defects which can cause quality issues in the part, as well as aesthetically it might look bad on the product. Right? So bridging, vertical axis holes, overhang, warping, and vertical pins. Bridging in FDM occurs when the printer is required to print between two supports or anchor points. So if in this case, if there is no additional support created, then you might see some issues with the bridging or sagging. A solution to avoid sagging is to include support. After the removal, it can leave marks or damage on the surface. So you might need a post-processing on support removal in this location. Vertical axis hole. When the part has a hole inside, when the design has a hole inside and a user is trying to manufacture with the additive manufacturing process, due to some of the compression, pre-compression, post-compression, and stresses that occurs during the printing process, it will cause a deformation of shape of the hole. So compressing force from the nozzle deforms the extruded round layer shape from the circle into a wider and flatter shape. That means the final part which is being achieved will not be similar to what was initially in the design. This can be an issue, particularly when printing small diameter holes, where the effect is greater due to the ratio of hole diameter to the nozzle diameter. Now, overhang constraint or overhang issues are one of the most common print quality problems related to Altair. You can see in the image, we have a CAD which has a different overhang angles. So 45 degrees most commonly used angle for orienting a part while printing, because at this particular degree angle, you can achieve a part without creating any additional support. Now, if you have any lower degree of angle, then you might need additional supports. Otherwise, you will see some deformities in the part. As you can see, we have 35 degrees, 30, 25, 20 degrees. You can see how the deformation can occur if no supports are being created. Warping, an issue that is often present related to first print layer of an FBM print, which is warping, and is most common thing as well. A different section of the print cool at different rates, meaning the first layer is already printed, which is cooling down. Meanwhile, another layer is being printed on top of it. So due to this temperature difference, temperature gradient, the dimension also changes at different speed. And that can cause warping defect. Similarly, we have small diameter pins, which can be made up only perimeter pins with no fill, and large pins are printed with a perimeter and infill, affording a strong connection to the rest of the print. This creates a discontinuity between the rest of the print and the pin, resulting in the pin connection that is susceptible to breaking. Also, porosity, residual stress, and cracking are another type of most important defects usually occurs in 3D metal printing. Porosity takes place during atomization process of metal powder, generates air pocket inside, which can be trapped inside the product during the printing process. Residual stress is also a crucial aspect of 3D metal printing, as it follows the rule of contraction during the cooling process and expansion of material due to heating and cooling. Now, when the residual stress breaches the threshold point of material tensile, chances of cracking becomes very much high due to this reason. This can cause compromisation of strength of the part, as well as aesthetically crack will look bad on it. Now, here is the image of typical crack propagation inside the part. 3D post-processing. Now, 3D printed parts are not ready to use out of the printer, right? You might have to do some cleanup as well as some post-processing in your output geometry. Necessary post-processing are depowdering and cleaning, support removal, which are most useful and needed post-processes for every 3D printed part. And some optional post-processes are there, for example, if you want to perform 3D metal printed part into a thermal treatments, smoothening of surfaces, polishing of the surfaces, water tightness, dyeing, or CNC machining. Machine prep and build phase. You can see from step 1, the machine is being filled with the powder, installing the build platform, checking the recorder blades for any kind of damages, then excess powder is transported into the workflow. Step 5 is apply start layer to the build platform, and then submitting a job for the printing process. After printing is done, after the job is done or built, it has to be removed from the machine. This is a critical step within the entire process, because the following parameters can be affected: turnaround time, part quality, and powder loss, ensuring the safety, cleaning of the machine, removal of the platform. There are several methods to perform the heat treatment, using electrical furnace, vacuum furnace, and heat treatment temperature depends on expected final properties. For example, in the box we have some materials and heat treatment temperature suggested. Support removal can be achieved into various methods using vise, hammer and chisel, dies, punches, rotary tools with various speeds and angle grinder. So here we have a slide that shows same design or same part with different optimization shape. One which is the original design with so many supports, and other one with optimal design without any supports. Blasting is another process which is used to remove the powder from the surface of the printed part. There are various types of blasting beads: original, nutshell, ceramic beads, steel beads, and special type of beads.